लगता है कि हिंसराज में गांधी जी ने मॉडर्निटी को बहुत अच्छी तरह समझाने का प्रयत्न किया है. रियली अंडरस्टूड मॉडर्निटी. और मॉडर्निटी जब मैं कहता हूँ तो मतलब उसमें जो आधुनिक सिस्टम्स में ये जो होता है कि आदमी स्वतंत्रता से परतंत्रता की ओर बढ़ता है और वो परतंत्र होते हुए भी अपने को स्वतंत्र मानता है, ये उसका और है. ज्यादा से ज्यादा अपनी चीजों पे उसका अधिकार, his right over the things that he needs, whether tangible or intangible, he loses control over them, and at the same time he feels that he is becoming more free. In today's terminology I can say more developed, he is making progress. So Gandhiji has deconstructed modernity in such a way, and I mean I like the way he's put it, in the sense he's picked up five main instruments of modernity: the modern judicial system, the modern governance system of parliamentary democracy, the modern technology, the modern education system, and the modern health system. And he has really, you know, opened it threadbare to see that how it is taking us towards more and more servility and becoming a cog in, you know, a small part in the whole machinery called the system. You know, so, you know, unless we understand this, you know, so you understand the whole material world today, how it operates, how people feel helpless, even though they may have money and facilities, but they, at the end of the day, they feel helpless, they can't do anything. You don't know where the water in your taps is coming from, where the electricity is coming from. Your children are going to a school, you have no, you don't know what is happening there, and if you feel that, no, this should not happen, and the child must go to a different kind of a education process, you have no choice, you can't send it there. You have a choice between a Pepsi and a Coca-Cola, but you don't have choice to drink water, a clean drinking water from your well, because wells are closed, the lakes are dirty, the river is polluted. So you end up buying a Bisleri bottle, and there are many choices there. So you can buy Aqua, this thing or that or that, but there's no choice. So they say there's, you know, it's open, you have so many choices in the market. The choices are very limited in a certain way, and gives the illusion that there's a lot of choice. This is what I feel that Gandhi has, really brought out. And other than Hinsuraj, I think Mahatma Gandhi is also very relevant, because, you know, he dares. You know, we don't have that kind of strength. I mean, I'll give you an example. And I'm really impressed by that. Two things I'll just say and then I'll finish. One is that during Jallianwala Bagh episode, when it happened and the whole country is up in flames, Gandhiji has the guts to say that these people who died in Jallianwala Bagh were not martyrs. Had they been martyrs, then they would have had bullets in their chest. But all of them died with bullets in the back, so they were running away. Now the point is, it's not a question of debating whether he was right or he was wrong. The point I'm trying to make is that he had the guts to say something against even the public opinion at that time. His distinctions are so sharp. His clarity is so sharp. So it strikes me that whenever he's arrested and the judge asks him, "Are you guilty?" And Gandhi says, "Yes, I am." He never says, "No, I'm not guilty." Unlike today's activists, you know, they are breaking the law, but they don't say that we are guilty. Gandhi is breaking a law and he says, "Yes, I'm guilty." And then after a gap, he says, "But according to your law." So he is making a distinction between Samvidhan and Vidhan. Samvidhan is man-made. Vidhan is not man-made. So he pleads from the position of Vidhan. He steps out of the boundaries of Samvidhan and he takes a different position, and then he pleads. And then he tells the judge, "You have now only two options. Either you give me the strongest possible punishment under your Samvidhan, or if you feel I am right, then you have to leave your chair." You know, this clarity is missing everywhere, I find, even today in the most noble people who have taken to activism, who are breaking the law of this country because they don't like certain things. They feel there's injustice. You know, even in Annahazare's movement, I found this missing. That no one is questioning that there are certain things which are right for all times. You know, if people are suffering and they want that to be redressed, then how can constitution come in between? If there is something wrong, constitution comes in between, if parliament comes in between, if any other institutions come in between, then that question, that institution needs to be reviewed, rather than saying that no, this is unconstitutional. You know, that kind of articulation is missing today in today's leadership. And he says that Tilak has spent 6 years in Mandale jail, and he's a brave man, but he did not understand India, Indian soul, and therefore his thing has not been so successful, because India is different from the West, and you know that difference needs to be understood. It's not that we are better or worse than them, but this difference is very important, and this needs to be understood. He gives an example somewhere where he's going down south, and he asks a farmer, an ordinary farmer, who's your king? And the farmer says, hoga koi, but asli to raja to wo hai. And Gandhi picks on this, and he says, he picks on this, and then he builds on it. He says, the Indian man, Indian ordinary person can be made fearless because he recognizes God. And if he has such a faith in God, then what has he got to fear? Why should he fear the British or the king? So, you know, Gandhi is building on Indian belief systems all the time. He's not rejecting them. He's not saying this is superstitious, this is all rubbish, these people are immersed in faith and all stupid things. He builds on it. That's what I like. And his courage, his fearlessness, you know, and his sharpness of the mind, his clarity, you know. He doesn't get into traps. We all tend to get into traps. Whenever we are arguing, we get into traps. Gandhi has the sharpness to step out of the categories, you know. He never allows categories to overpower him. I find that with all the awareness, and I keep talking about it, but in a clever argument with someone who's using clever argument, I get trapped in categories. And later on I realize, my God, why shouldn't have argued that way. That was not my point. But you know, the power of words, the power of categories, we all get caught into. He doesn't. He's very clear. I think main cheez ye hai ki ye jo pura system hota hai, jiske aadhar pe nation state chal rahi hai, aur world government bhi, UN bhi waise hi chal raha hai. वो जो उसमें ये है कि आदमी चुपचाप जो भी लॉ जिन लोगों ने भी बनाया है, जो सिस्टम्स बनाए हैं, उसके अंदर रह के चुपचाप अपने को उसमें जो कुछ करना करे, उसके बाहर स्टेप नहीं करे. और ये जकड़न, दिस ऑपरेशन ऑफ द सिस्टम इज सो सटल एंड सो रिमोट दैट यू कांट सी 200 इयर्स अगो आई कुड से इफ आई एम ऑप्रेस्ड एंड आई कुड सी द ऑपरेसर. I could identify the oppressor. Yeah, that king, that nawab, you know, that zamindar, he is the oppressor, or his karinda is the oppressor. Aaj to humko pata hi nahi hai. Aap jaiye, wo jo exploit kar raha hai, wo aapko bolega ki main kya karu? This is the law. Bhai, aisa niyam hai, aise rules hai. Hum kya kare? Aapke bachche ko admission nahi mila. Hum kya kare? Aisa rule hai. Wo koi aadmi nahi hai. Wo rule ho gaya. Wo rule ko kahan pakadne jaun main? तो ये जो सिस्टम का ऑपरेशन है, ये नेशनलिज्म से मैं इसका लिंक देखता हूँ. मेरे को अदरवाइज, मेरे को आई एम प्राउड, आई एम हैप्पी टू बी एन इंडियन, यू नो, एंड आई डोंट इवन माइंड रेजिंग माय फ्लैग, यू नो, वंस इन अ वाइल. सो व्हाट, पॉइंट वो नहीं है, दीज आर ऑल सिंबल्स. पॉइंट ये है कि ये जो सो कॉल्ड इंडियन स्टेट है, और इंडियन स्टेट बदल के मान लो हम कोई और देश में चले जाएं, तो वहां की जो स्टेट है, वो जो सिस्टम है ना, सिस्टम सारी जगह एक जैसे है. और ये सिस्टम्स जो हैं, ये हम लोगों को विली नीली ये बोल रहे हैं कि तुम इनको मानो, इसके अंदर रहो, बी ओबीडियंट सिटीजन, बी ओबीडियंट सिटीजन ऑफ योर कंट्री और ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, बट बी ओबीडियंट सिटीजन. ओबीडियंस इज व्हाट दे वांट. नाउ ओबीडियंस टू व्हाट? नॉट टू विधान. but to samvidhan. Obedience to vidhan will bring a sense of responsibility in me. Then I will be self-regulated, and that is swatantrata. But these people are claiming that system, man-made system, you have to, usme aapko obedience chahiye, usme aap responsible citizen banke chaliye, phir aap rights ki ladai ladte rahiye, vagara, 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 vagara. You are not happy with the system. You are not happy with the education system. You are not happy with XYZ system. But you still want to remain within the system. And you are unhappy with the system. So you go into the system and you say, yes, I am unhappy with the system, but I will stay within the system. I will agree with whatever the system demands and try to change it from within. This is a illusion. This is not possible. I think we should sometimes talk about it. Not that is it at all possible to be in the system and to change the system. We should have a workshop or a conference or a course on it, whether it is possible. Theoretically, let's see whether it's possible. I don't think it's possible at all to be within it and change it. You can modify it. You cannot change it. You cannot change it fundamentally. It will not allow it. So you have to step out. I think that's what I mean, Rinpoche Ji has been talking about this, you know, stepping out. You have a chance to change it. I'm not saying that that's a sure way to change it, but there is a chance. In that, there is no chance. So I feel there are two kinds of people who talk about this, that we will change the system from within. There's one lot who's actually talking, who's trying to take you for a ride. They also don't want to change it. They know they cannot change it, but they want to be on. They want to, you know, be part of the system and part of this crowd also, who's against the system. And they say, no, we are like you, but you know, we're just taking a different approach. So they are actually bluffing you. Now I'm saying these people need to be exposed. They need to be exposed in the sense that we should not, exposed by that, I don't mean they need to be hammered. All I mean is that we should be very clear that they are, you know, they are like that. They don't have real issues with the system. But there's another lot who actually believe they can change it from within. I think they need to be educated. You know, they actually believe. But I think it's like, it's a contradiction in terms. And we need to understand the whole dynamics of a system. And when you, how system does, will not permit you to change it from within. It has enough flexibility to accommodate a lot of dissent, you know. It has it is an inbuilt capacity. Systems are made that way. That it will tolerate dissent up to a limit. It will tolerate certain divergences, you know. It's not a straight jacket in a sense that, you know, it has a lot of tolerance, it's a lot of flexibility. So these people who are genuine people, who are making good efforts, but they remain in this illusion that we can change it from within, I think they need to be told. And this is where, I mean, I would say many people, you know, who think that, oh, this, you know, ye virodh karna, ye sab to garbad hai, ye virodh se to kuch nahi hota hai. ये अपोज करके तो कुछ नहीं होगा अब ये सब ये भी वर्ड्स का ही खेल है यू नो व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय विरोध विरोध डजंट मीन दैट गो किसी के जाकर डंडा मारना है यू नो विरोध इज बीइंग जैसे गांधी जी भी विरोध करते थे डंडा तो नहीं मारा किसी को बट सेइंग थिंग्स फोर्थराइटली समटाइम्स सीधा सीधी बात करना आप भुलावे में जब रखते हैं ना लोगों को वो गड़बड़ चीज है सर्टेन थिंग्स हैव टू बी वेरी क्लियर